morning. I'm Courtney Johns. Maya's on assignment. Today is Tuesday, March 24th, and we'll have a look at those top stories in just a moment. But first, we got to talk about the weather with Weather Alert Team meteorologist Mark Stitz. And Mark, it's springtime, which that means we also have to talk about severe weather.
We do. Luckily, none in the forecast for this week, but Severe Weather Awareness Week is this week, Courtney, which always means time to review those weather safety things heading into severe weather safety season.
You know, and I know a lot of it for you probably seems repetitive, but I think it's really helpful for a lot of people as reminders on everything from the watch to the warning and all of this.
Yeah, and our weather kind of clubs that we're in tell us that their research shows that people do need reminded of these things. So even if it's super basic to you, just know that your neighbor may need a quick little review lesson. So that's why we do kind of harp on this once a year heading into severe weather season. So today we're going to talk about thunderstorms, some severe and some non-severe, and both are dangerous. So let's start with what you do to stay safe just during a regular thunderstorm, so below severe levels. First of all, stay inside. That's the number one thing you can do with any thunderstorm. It's going to protect you from the hail, the lightning, and the winds, again, even if it's not severe. Stay away from windows, stay away from pipes and electronics that are plugged into the wall. Again, all those things, especially areas like metal pipes and the wiring in your home, if lightning strikes outside, that electricity can actually travel through those things and electrocute you whether you're in the shower or sitting on a corded phone. So again, those things not as common as they used to be, but just still a quick reminder on some of that thunderstorm safety. Now when it comes to severe storms, obviously get inside number one, and honestly, better safe than sorry, head to your safe room in your house. Again, some thunderstorms can have straight line winds, even stronger than a weak tornado. So again, you want to take those severe thunderstorms very seriously as well. I know a lot of people think of tornadoes as being worse, but sometimes severe storms can actually be worse than lower end tornadoes. Now, what does it take to actually be a severe storm by definition? You need one of two things. First of all, you need 1 inch hail in diameter. That's about the size of a quarter, or you could have strong winds, again, straight line winds around 60 miles per hour or greater. So you don't need both of them. Some storms have one, some storms have both. Doesn't matter, either one, you have a severe storm. So that's when it's gonna get a warning on it from the National Weather Service. So how these storms form? Well, first of all, we get a warm updraft. That could be caused by a cold front. It could be caused by the afternoon heating of the day. Either way, you need warm rising into the atmosphere, and that's what's gonna start to cause some those clouds outside in the afternoon. Eventually, those clouds get even higher into the air if the air is unstable enough, which is very common in the spring or summer, and you get those big towering cumulus clouds. Eventually, those clouds start to give way to rainfall, and that helps to cause a cold downdraft. So you have wind going up in the storm, and you have wind going down into the storm as well, coming back out of it. And eventually, some of this, well, it gets high enough in the atmosphere that those clouds reach the freezing line. So eventually, some of that rainfall starts to push above the freezing line, obviously turning into some small ice. And now that process is going to repeat. The ice gets heavy, it starts to fall, and the warm updraft pushes it back up, and that cycle repeats. So basically, that hail gets in the warm part of the storm, collects a little bit of rainfall on it, then it moves back into the colder part of the storm and starts to freeze up. And again, you do that over and over, and that hail gets larger and larger. Eventually, the updraft can't hold it any longer, and that's when it falls out of the storm as hail. So that's how things work. And again, we'll be talking more severe weather safety through the rest of the week. Courtney?